A few days back, I made this video in Tamil, and I thought I should make in English as well about Bhagavad Gita. Basically, whoever some of you would have already read Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and some of you probably would have not read. But for all the people who have read or not read, we have to understand some facts about Bhagavad Gita. Number one, Bhagavad Gita is not written by Sri Krishna Maharaj. I think most of you know it. Bhagavad Gita is an extract from Mahabharat, and Mahabharat is written was written by Vyas Muni. And Mahabharat, in that Mahabharat, several hundred years back, somebody took 18 chapters from Mahabharat and then printed it as Bhagavad Gita. It's not a issue to extract something from a book which is written by Rishi Muni and then giving that knowledge to public. It's not a problem. But the problem is to interpret or sorry misinterpret the teachings of Bhagavad Gita as a knowledge by itself. Basically, number one, we have to understand Sri Krishna Maharaj studied Vedas from his Acharya Guru Rishi Sandipan, and he studied Vedas, he did Ashtanga Yoga Tapasya, and he got enlightenment. This fact is mentioned in Mahabharat by Vyas Muni. So Sri Krishna Maharaj is not Almighty God, number one. And number two, Sri Krishna Maharaj studied Vedas, and in that Vedas, God has clearly told his quality Aja Ek Padaha in Rigveda. Aja, ja means Jananam, that is by birth. Aja means not taking birth. God never takes birth. God never takes avatar. And the same fact is also mentioned in Yajurveda 40 by 8 mantra. Shukram Akayam. Akayam. There is no body for God. There is no form for God. Natasya pratima asti, there is no photo of God, there is no statue of God, and that God does not take a form as an avatar. Avatar means coming down from somewhere. God, being omnipresent, cannot come down from anywhere because he is present up as well, he is present down, he is present left, right, everywhere. So Sri Krishna Maharaj is not avatar of Almighty God, and Sri Krishna Maharaj is not Almighty God. This is the fact we have to understand before studying Bhagavad Gita. Okay. The next point is, if at all, if that be the case, you may have to understand, and you would wonder that many slokas in Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna Maharaj says that I am the originator of Vedas, I created this universe, I give the karma phala, and many things where Sri Krishna Maharaj tells I, aham, aham. So the secret behind this is basically, as Patanjali Rishi in his Yoga Shastra Sutra says that, whatever statement you are reading, it has to be tallying with Vedas. Yoga Shastra Sutra 1 by 7. Agama Pramanani. Either it has to tally with Vedas or it has to tally with the words of a Rishi Muni. So if you have to tally with Vedas, Sri Krishna Maharaj says, I created this universe, then we have to tally it with Vedas to understand whether it is right or wrong. If we think that it is wrong, then we have to understand the underlying meaning of why Sri Krishna says like this. Again, coming to the Samaveda says, and also Rigveda says, Brahma Devanam Padavi. And Samaveda says that Prichamanaha Gavayanti means this Ved mantras originates from within the Acharya, within the Rishi Muni, within the Yogeshwar. Ved mantra emanates from Almighty God. Prichamanaha, it asks, Ved Mata is delivered from Almighty God and it is spoken out from the mouth of a Yogeshwar. That is why in some of the shlokas, if Sri Krishna Maharaj says, I created this universe, this means, I means Almighty God, not Sri Krishna Maharaj's body. Sri Krishna Maharaj is not alive today. He is already gone heavenly abode and he is in moksha now. So Sri Krishna Maharaj, when he was in his body, he is giving the knowledge about karma, jnana and upasana to Arjun. And at that context, he was a Yogeshwar, and from within him, Almighty God was uttering some words. And those shlokas we cannot misinterpret and say that Sri Krishna Maharaj created this universe. Sri Krishna Maharaj gave the Ved knowledge. No, this is wrong. And Brahma Devanam Padavi. The Padavi means sentence. The sentence uttered by a Dev, by a Acharya, by a Yogeshwar is from Almighty God Brahma himself. And it is Ved mantra. The translation of Ved mantras emanates from the mouth of a yogi in his language, whatever language he speaks. It could be Sanskrit, it could be Hindi, it could be Tamil, it could be any language, German, French, etc. So the Ved mantra knowledge emanates from a yogi. And a yogi cannot create a universe. It's not a yogi who has created this universe. This universe is created by formless almighty God who never takes birth, who never goes into death. Okay, and now coming to Gita, as I already told, Gita is an extract from Mahabharata. The knowledge there in Gita can be understood only if we have a Ved knowledge. And obviously 99.9999999% of people living today do not have Ved knowledge. So how do we understand Gita? The only way to understand Gita is to read a Gita which is written by a person who is equivalent to Sri Krishna Maharaj. Who has attained Samadhi, Dharmic Samadhi as mentioned in Yoga Shastra. Who has released Almighty God as mentioned in Atharveda Mantra, saying that Tam Rishim Tam Sumedam Tam Brahmanam. When somebody attains Almighty God, God Himself makes him Brahman, the knower of Brahma. God Himself give him Alaukik Shuddh Buddhi. That means a pure consciousness, pure intellect. So that person, if he has written a book, then we can read Bhagavad Gita to understand exactly what Sri Krishna Maharaj told. Because in some shlokas, Sri Krishna Maharaj says indirectly. Some shlokas, Sri Krishna Maharaj says directly. Some shlokas, Sri Krishna Maharaj says as a secret Sri Krishna person. So this exactly can be understood only by a person who is equivalent to Sri Krishna, that is a Samadhist Yogeshwar. Okay, and another main point is Sri Krishna Maharaj learnt Vedas from his Acharya. The author of Bhagavad Gita is Vyas Muni. Vyas Muni, all of us know that we call him Ved Vyas. He is an authority in Vedic scriptures and Vedas. And so that means we can read Bhagavad Gita, which is giving references to Veda mantras. Okay, and in fact, if you read, there are so many shlokas, 700 plus shlokas in Bhagavad Gita. If you read the third chapter, 15th shloka, there Sri Krishna Maharaj himself says that the knowledge of Vedas emanating from Almighty God. And this knowledge of Vedas is given by Almighty God to the four rishis at the start of this universe. Agni, Vayu, Angira, Aditya, and this process is eternal. This universe will get over. Bhagavad Gita will not be there in the next prithvi, in the next srishti. Not even one man-made book will be available in the next srishti. All the books which we know today, every book will get destroyed. Only Vedic knowledge will be existing in the next srishti because Vedas are not books. Because Vedas are Nitya Jnana. Nitya means eternal knowledge. Eternal knowledge is always unwritten. So the book what I have in my hand, I have shown this in many, many videos. Atharva Veda Sahita, Rig Veda Sahita, I have Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda. These are Sahita, these are printed text of Veda Mantra. This is not Vedas. Even if I speak a Veda Mantra, I say Vishwani Deva Savitar Duritani Parasuva, I say a Veda Mantra to you, an Ajurveda, and explain to you, God says like this, this is the Veda Mantra meaning, this is not called as Vedas, this is called as Sahita, because I am uttering this, because I am a normal human being. Although I am learning from my Acharya, I am not eligible person to teach Vedas to anyone, because God says in Yajurveda 40 by 10 that you have to listen this knowledge only from a Dhir Purush, Samadhist Purush. Then only it is called as Vedas. If Sri Krishna Maharaj is uttering this to Arjuna, Arjuna is listening Vedas. Arjuna is not listening Mahabharata or Bhagavad Gita, because Sri Krishna did not tell that I am giving you Gita Gyan. Sri Krishna gave him the knowledge of Vedas because Sri Krishna is learned of Vedas. If I learn English, I am speaking to you in English. Why I am able to speak in English? Because I learned English. If I don't know English, how can I speak in English? Similarly, Sri Krishna Maharaj learned Vedas. He is speaking the Vedic knowledge to Arjuna. And secondly, he is telling this to Arjuna, not to you, not to me, not to anyone else. So in order for us to understand exactly what Sri Krishna told, we have to understand from a person who is equivalent to Sri Krishna. So in market today, there are, I would say 18, 20 or even 30 publications of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, yet only in Hindi and English. In Tamil, there are more publications of Srimad Bhagavad Gita written by any Tom, Dick and Harry. But we cannot read those Bhagavad Gita to understand the real meaning of Bhagavad Gita. The one book I have read in my life, I am not saying this because I am following my Guruji. The only book in this world, another book cannot be written by a human being is like this is the book of Bhagavad Gita written by my Acharya, because the book I have, this is part one, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Ek Vaidik Rahasya in Hindi. Every shloka of Sri Krishna Maharaj, from which Veda mantra it got the knowledge, from which Veda mantra Sri Krishna got this knowledge, that secret is mentioned in this book. That is why this book is called Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Ek Vaidik Rahasya. This is the secret of Vedas. And we have to understand Bhagavad Gita with reference to the Veda mantras, and cannot be interpreted by individual shlokas. Veda mantra says Shruti Shrut Karana and Shrutam Tapah. Listening Vedas is called tapasya. Reading Vedas is not tapasya. You can read Veda mantra after listening it from an acharya, and that Veda mantra, if it is written by the same acharya or by any other acharya who has realized Almighty God, who is a Rishi Muni. So Srimad Bhagavad Gita, many people have misinterpreted Srimad Bhagavad Gita today, and there is a lot of people who just believes that Sri Krishna is God. Sri Krishna is not God, cannot be God, and Sri Krishna never meant in any of the shloka that he is God. And the shlokas are personally told to Arjuna. Sri Krishna did not even think, or he did not had a slightest opinion that this knowledge will be read across by many people in the world. He gave that knowledge to Arjuna to inspire him to fight against the Adharma, fight against the false people who are spoiling the eternal Vedic culture. So that is the main motto of Sri Krishna Maharaj. And last but not least, Srimad Bhagavad Gita has, of course, Vedic knowledge, but it has, I would say, very, very limited knowledge. Bhagavad Gita do not have science knowledge. Bhagavad Gita do not have agricultural knowledge. Bhagavad Gita do not have atomic energy. Bhagavad Gita do not have other properties of science, other properties of matter. Bhagavad Gita do not have how to manufacture clothes. Bhagavad Gita do not have medicinal knowledge. Bhagavad Gita do not have the secrets about human body. Some knowledge, very very few knowledge is available in Gita. The ocean of knowledge is in Vedas. And from the ocean of knowledge, Sri Krishna Maharaj realized inside his heart, and he exactly chose only few knowledge to inspire Arjuna to fight the war. That's the purpose, that's the main motto of Sri Krishna, to tell this to Arjuna. Sri Krishna would never have thought that my knowledge would have been misinterpreted by self-made gurus to make money. He would have never thought, I believe. This is and Sri Krishna Maharaj is still there today in moksha, and he would definitely be feeling that how come my knowledge is being misinterpreted by people for their own business needs. And in one of the shlokas he says, yada yada hi dharmasya, I will come back to ensure that dharma is sustained. This is does not mean that he is an avatar. This means this is his own personal sankalp. Sri Krishna Maharaj as an individual has a sankalp, has a wish, and this wish is coming from Atharva Veda, where God says, God gives this power to a yogi, that a yogi can take a birth at any point of time at his own accord, at his own will. This is a proof available in Atharva Veda mantra, and if you read the Bhagavad Gita written by my Acharya, you will understand why Sri Krishna Maharaj told like this. So Sri Krishna Maharaj probably has come many times, we don't know, because these are Rishi Munis, yogis who can come at any point of time to help people, help Jigyasu, help people to go towards Vedic path. But we cannot misinterpret this as Sri Krishna Maharaj is the avatar, he will come as a Bhagavan Kalki, he will come as another Bhagavan, etc, etc, etc. This is a wrong misinterpretation, that is why this is misinterpretation. So do not read Bhagavad Gita written by a person who is self-declaring himself as a Ved Vidwan. How do you find out a person is a Ved Vidwan or not? Very, very simple. If a person is building temple, if a person is building a statue of Sri Krishna Maharaj, and a person says that he is Almighty God, then of course he does not know anything Vedas. This is a basic test we can find out, which is who can be a Ved Vidwan or not. So because it is against Vedas, Anantamaha Pravishanti, I have explained in the previous videos, please see that there is no temple worship in Vedas. So anyone who is writing Bhagavad Gita also has a temple, he has a statue of Sri Krishna and he worships Sri Krishna, then that means the Gita written by him is not authentic. So I request you to revert back to the original Bhagavad Gita explained by my Acharya, or probably there could be one or two Ved Vidwans. I really don't know, but if it's a Ved Vidwan, please read that Bhagavad Gita. If it is not a Ved Vidwan, that Bhagavad Gita which you would have read completely would have given you false knowledge. Thank you so much. I will meet you soon in another video. Sabko namaste. Om.